The first-gen identity is an invisible one. You wouldn't know that someone was first-generation if they didn't say it. And it is one that is, in certain ways, disadvantaged. But then, there's definitely a lot of things to be proud of for being first-gen, too.
Since we see a lot of new faces, I guess it's pretty simple based on our title, but we're the club for FGLI, or first-gen low-income students on campus. We're really excited to have you.
I am the president and co-founder of the undergraduate student organization called FLIP at BostonU, and FLIP stands for First Generation Low Income Partnership. A first-generation college student is someone whose parents, guardians, or caregivers did not go to college themselves or did not complete college in the United States. So our club is for first-gen and or low-income students, as we recognize that not every first-generation student is low-income and vice versa, but oftentimes those two are linked. And so we try to do both social community-building events as well as sort of academic pre-professional events.
There you go.
And just... Ooh! There we go.
I love that.
Thank you.
Oh my
God. No matter how long we take for these e-webinars, we always run over. So like, I appreciate y'all's patience. The other graduating members of our e-ward are Annie, our vice president, and Cecilia, our treasurer. And it's a really special time for us because we're the first in our families to graduate.
Hola, chica.
¿Cómo estás?
Bien, ¿y vos cómo estás?
Bien.
¿Dónde están tus maletas ya empacadas?
Ya, solo esperando el día.
FLIP is a club that I would have loved to have my freshman year because my parents don't know what it is to be in college. My mom babysits and my dad has a job at a supermarket. I'm super proud of them, but I can't ask them, like, how do you go on LinkedIn? How do I make a resume? They can't say, maybe BU has a resource that can help you do this. And I think that a lot of the problems that I like kind of dealt with sometimes would come from that first gen low income identity. And before FLIP, there wasn't really anything on campus for that.
Being first gen, it's having to figure everything out on your own. And then like the low income experience is that you do have to balance work life, school life, social life. Not only do you have homework, but you have to go to work, like real work. A lot of FGLI students, they're balancing 2-3 jobs, and I feel like that's something that a lot of students don't understand. So when FLIP meets, it's a space to really talk about things like that.
Yeah, people want, they can start grabbing pizza. So yes, pepperoni, cheese, veggie.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Oh, it didn't go with the second one. That's so embarrassing.
Feel free to grab boba and pizza and sit places. But yeah, I just know if we just want to start by talking about in general, how did y'all feel today?
It feels really nice to know there's like other people in the same situation as me, very similar. It is difficult like coming into college, not knowing like what to expect, like not having a parent that can be like your mentor. Because like I have friends that like their parents are like, you know, they went to college. They got like a master's degree. They got like a PhD. They're like CEOs or lawyers or doctors.
It's tough. Like people ask, what do your parents do for a living? It's just, it comes with a sense of like, okay, how do I prepare myself? How do I cushion it? Like if my mom is a babysitter, can I be like, oh, she just educates?
Yes, it sucks sometimes, but I don't know, the feeling I get when there's people that are in the same position that I am, meaning like they're at BU and their parents are like doctors, they went to Harvard. Mm-hmm. I'm like, my dad was a construction worker, we're in the same place.
Like there are a lot of pressures and burdens and like feelings that come with being FGLI and like, a lot of them can be negative, but like, how do you all deal with them, I guess? Or like, what motivates you to like keep going?
Just being in this room, like seeing other people like me and just knowing that I'm not the only one struggling, that has been something that has helped me a lot, just knowing that I'm not alone and just that this is something to be proud of. Like, we are the first. That is already crazy. Like, the fact that we're here in the first place, like, got through the whole college application kind of by ourselves, FAFSA by ourselves. We are like 18 to 20 figuring out taxes. That's kind of crazy. And just the fact that we did it in the first place, I feel like it's just a lot of pride that built up as I've gotten to this point.
FLIP has definitely taught me to not be afraid to talk about my FGLI experiences, and being able to like have those conversations with other FGLI students has really been one of the highlights of my college experience.
I'm very happy that I can pass on FLIP because it's super important for us to be advocating on behalf of first gen, and it's something that I hope stays forever at BU.
I'm really glad to see that our club will live on. I came in without it, and so just thinking about the fact that there will be people who enter BU who have never known a time without FLIP, like that's really awesome.
Good evening and welcome to the Newberry Center's second annual first generation graduation pinning ceremony. Tonight we are honoring 156 of our first generation undergraduate, graduate, and professional students, both in person and virtually through our live stream. I especially want to take a moment to highlight our first generation Low Income Partnership Chapter, or FLIP at Boston U. Prior to the Newberry Center's establishment, a group of first-gen and low-income background students came together on their own during the height of the pandemic to create their own student organization. FLIP at Boston U is now the official undergraduate student organization of the Newberry Center. Maelee Chen, Annie Hallett, Cecilia Jarquin Tapia, you've left a lasting legacy for future first-gen undergraduates.
I'm insanely grateful. My literal single mom working like 6 days a week would be like, don't do anything, like just do your schoolwork, just focus on academics. And so I want to repay her, and I don't know if that's possible, but using the most of this academic opportunity is one way that I would be able to say, you know, like, thank you for doing all these things for me. And this is what I've done with myself from this gift.
I'm really proud of myself. It's a big step to be the first person in your family to graduate. And I think I'm more proud to do it for my family than anything. And I feel like a lot of first gens feel like that. It's sort of a relief moment because it's like, you finally did it. They finally get to see all of their dreams come true.
First gen students aren't likely to graduate. Low income students aren't likely to graduate. So to be an example of someone who is successful means so much to me. Because anyone who's at BU can say, well, she did it, I can do it too.
Cecilia Jarquin Tapia.